Ponzi schemes continue to feature prominently in the global financial system, and since Ghana plays an active role in the global financial economy, investors within Ghana ought to take note of the schemes being adopted by these Ponzi peddlers in order not to lose their valuables in terms of investment in this kind of Ponzi schemes, specifically with regards to teaser fund Ghana. Since SEC has come out to state that they are not a regulated entity, the general public should please cease from investing with teaser Ghana fund, because the rate of return on the investment being charged by Teaser Fund Ghana Limited, 50% within 10 days, as against the policy rate of Ghana, which is currently hovering around 13.5% per annum, is not sustainable, because no investment can yield 50% interest within a period of 10 days. So this is clear example of a Ponzi scheme being executed by the Teaser Fund Ghana Limited. Investors shouldn't be swayed by the high interest rate being charged. It's a way of baiting them into such unsustainable what ventures. So usually the general public should compare the rate of return to the rate of return being charged by these companies to that of the policy rate before investing in such schemes. The general public also need not to be greedy for quick returns. There are other alternative investments that the general public can invest their funds in and have safer returns on their investment. Things like bonds guarantees the investor a safer return than engaging in risky investments like that of the Teaser Fund Ghana Limited. So the general public should please desist in engaging in such investment with such companies. Likewise, the general public should also verify from the SEC database anytime they want to make any investment with this regard, to check whether the companies are registered with the Securities and Exchange Commission to authenticate their validity before investing in such investment. To the regulators within the space, I would suggest SEC collaborate with the Ghana Police, specifically with the cyber crime units of the Ghana Police, collaborate with the National Cyber Crime Authority to conduct a forensic analysis into the activities of Teaser Fund Ghana Limited, and if found culpable, they should be prosecuted to serve as a deterrent to those who would also want to embark on this criminal hot activity.